It's about a family who's been through a horrible tragedy, and they didn't deal with that tragedy in a good way, so they let evil into their lives. And now to atone for the bad things that happened, they let an orphanage come live in their house, the all-girl orphanage, which is a really bad idea, because then evil happens to all of them, with, of course, Annabelle being in the center of all of this. Yes, Samuel makes dolls, dollhouses, a very sort of handyman. And in the movie, he, you know, after this accident, he gets very withdrawn and kind of mysterious. So the girls who move into this house are kind of scared of him, especially at first, because they don't really know what he's up to. Because he doesn't talk a lot, and he's mostly just acting strange, because he knows something that they'll soon find out. Well, Linda is a little bit more naive, while Janice is very, I mean, she's been through a lot. She has polio, she's not had a very fun life, so she's a bit more jaded and a little bit more broken down compared to Linda, who's still very happy puppy and is like, oh, this is great, and, you know. And both of those girls, you don't want to see them get hurt just because they're so innocent. Yeah, Miranda Otto and Anthony LaPaglia is the Mullins. Very happy that they wanted to be in the film, you know, because they just feel like such classy actors, you know. You've seen them in all these things, and they're just great. They just sold their characters right away, and very happy that they could be in the film. Samara was awesome, because she's 8 years old, but she's a huge horror fan. So when I first met her, I was like, you know, Samara, that's actually the name of a famous horror character from The Ring. And she's like, yeah, I know, I love that movie. I'm actually named after her. It's like, oh, okay. And she was, I mean, when we were shooting Annabelle 2, Conjuring 2 just came out. And she went and saw that like 5 times in the theaters. Like, she's a huge horror fan. So when James, one day when James came by the set, that was like the highlight for her to actually meet him. And she was always like, I'm wanting to do more horror stuff in the movie, and like asking me like, hey, can't you let me do this or do that? Because she was so into it. I think what makes Annabelle creepy, besides the fact that she looks pretty creepy, is that James just did such a great job with setting her up in that first Conjuring. So now she has this kind of feeling of dread attached to her, which is like, you know, seeing this movie in theaters, you see that people, like, they react as soon as she comes up on screen. And even on the set, it was like actors like Stephanie, who was like, do I have to touch the doll? Like, I don't want to touch it. So I think that's a credit to James to having really created this mythology around. I think it's very exciting how this is evolving, you know, from just The Conjuring to now the Annabelle franchise, and now it's going into The Nun as well. And it's fun how they all go together, and you know, there is this established timeline, how they all piece together. And it's fun how, like, The Conjuring has this more investigative aspect, you know, since it's based on the Warren files, while Annabelle, while still being based on the real doll, is a little bit more freer in that it's not based on any particular events. So you can sort of go a little bit more crazy in the scares department, I think.
Hey, Vale here. Now, a lot of effort goes into making a movie, and this, the Exorcist behind the scenes fact, goes to show it. William Friedkin had a shotgun with blank shells that he'd shoot off on the soundstage during breaks. It scared the daylights out of everybody. And after a few times, he was asked to stop. The actors didn't find it funny. What they didn't know was that their reactions were being filmed and later inserted into the movie as their reaction when Regan made a sound upstairs. Okay, so if you want to watch more videos like this, hit the subscribe button and ring the notification bell so you receive the videos the moment they are online. See you next time.